The goal about the vision, Jesus was very clear, John was very clear, you too must be clear. When you ask Jesus, who are you? He will tell you who he is. Actually, when he is born, the vision was clear. She shall bring forth a son and call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Jesus is called Jesus Christ, or the Savior, the anointed Messiah, the Savior. His very purpose was very set in the beginning. He comes as a Savior. Goals are clear. Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Amen. I am the way, the truth, and the life. The goals are very clear. If you want the truth, you find it in Jesus. If you find the way to God, you find it in Jesus. Jesus is the bread of life. He's the way, the truth, and the life. John says, I am the voice of one calling in the wilderness. Prepare ye the way of the Lord. The goals are very clear, and as soon as Jesus appeared, John knows that my time to exit has come, and I am going. Some of us, when your time to exit has arrived, you are still singing Pastor Nomtin in the music team, but you, your time is up. Your time is up. Your time is up. That's not a prophetic word, by the way. That's just an example. Your time is up. John knew when his time was up. We have some people, especially in Africa. In Africa, it's a problem. In Africa, it's a problem. Your time is up, Mr. President. Mr. President hangs on to power. Your goals must be clear. You must know why you're there. When your time is up, your time is up. Are you hearing what I'm saying, friends? Yeah. Time is up, time is up. Goals must be clear. When you set your goals, they must be clear. When you set the goals of your department, they must be clear. John was very clear. This is what God has called me to do. Go through all the men of God that you find in the scriptures, or anyone really who became significant. Their goals were clear. Joseph, it was very clear. He needed to serve Israel. That's why even if they did all the rough stuff to him, they threw him into the pit and sold him, and he's gone into the prison. At the end of it, the guy does not lose his vision. It is clear, crystal clear. God has sent me to preserve life on the earth. Are we together, saints?
Amen.
So even if when you go through problems, when you go through challenges, when you go through issues, when your goals are clear, those will not contaminate you. You know what? When you are pursuing vision, sometimes you can be contaminated. There are things that contaminate you. Amen. There are things that poison you. But what keeps you going, if your goal is clear, make sure that you stick on your lane. I've got a sermon called Stick on Your Lane and Run Your Race. You will hear it very soon.
Amen.
Amen. Goals must be clear. Number three, excuses. Number three, how vision works. Let's talk about excuses. The greatest enemy of vision. Listen to this guy. This guy says, sir, now Jesus asked a simple question. Do you want to be made well? And the guy goes for it, sir, I have no man to put me into the pool when the water is stirred up. But while I am coming, another steps down before me. The guy is giving excuses. And that's the greatest enemy of vision. Music team, why haven't you recorded? Ah, very high, I have no problem. I'm about to practice. Excuses. Are we together, saints? Excuses and excuses. And this is one of the greatest enemy to vision.
Thank you so much for staying tuned. Please note that we have midweek services every Tuesday and home groups every Wednesday around the city. Also, if you have prayer requests, feel free to visit our website just on bottom of the screen. From me, Thelma, thank you so much. Bye.